tech channel today is nothing without a PC build. So here I am with a powerful Ryzen PC build. This video will guide you through the testing part of the build, which is really important, but most of the people avoid doing it or don't know about it. First, let me tell you what I mean by parts testing and why is it necessary. Parts testing means to essentially build a PC outside the cabinet once and check if each component is working and is being recognized in the BIOS, and it is important because if you build the whole PC and then switch it on with the expectations of the world and then it does not work, that would be bad, right? So if you are gonna build a PC soon, don't forget to test the components outside the box first. Now let's get started with the video. The first thing you will need is a screwdriver. I have a toolkit here. You will also need your monitor, processor, motherboard, one RAM stick and a power supply unit or SMPS. You will also need your graphics card if your processor does not have an integrated GPU. Once you are done with the inventory, now take your motherboard out of its box and we'll use it as a test bench. First, let's insert the processor in the motherboard. I will explain you how to do that in detailed steps in my build guide, which will be uploaded very soon if I get a good response in this video. Now place the CPU cooler on top of the CPU and screw it in place. Connect the fan of the CPU cooler to the motherboard using the fan header. Next, let's insert the RAM in the RAM slot. Even if you have multiple sticks, only one will be enough to start up the PC. You can also plug your hard drive in if you want to check it, but that is not necessary as hard drives can be easily removed even after completing the build. Next, let's connect the power cables. First, connect the 24-pin power cable, then connect the 8-pin power cable. Now we'll install the GPU. I prefer to connect the GPU at last because it is heavy and without the support of the case, I don't want to push my motherboard over its limits. Connect the 6-pin or 8-pin power cable to the GPU and you are pretty much good to go. You just need to connect the monitor to the HDMI port on the GPU and we are done. Anything else? No. Now how to switch the computer on? We don't have a switch. Well, some motherboards do have a switch, but most of them don't. So if you have a motherboard which does not have a power switch, don't you worry. Technoking to the rescue here. Open up your motherboard's manual and look for the page which has front IO connectors or system panel connectors on it. Once you open the page, look for the PWR SW label and remember those pins. In my case, they are the 3rd and 4th pins starting from the top left. Now all you need to do is touch these two pins with a screwdriver and you must see your CPU fan turning on. This indicates that your PC is switched on. Now wait for something to appear on your monitor. Ryzen systems do take a little bit longer on their first starts. Voila! Our computer works, the RAM is recognized, the processor is recognized and the GPU is obviously recognized as you are getting a display on the monitor. Now if everything has worked out for you till now, well and good. You can now go ahead and build your PC. But if something goes wrong, first of all check all the connections before jumping to any conclusions. And if the computer works at this stage, that's awesome. But if it does not work even then check for the connections once again and make sure that everything is right. Make sure that the power switch pins that you are touching with your screwdriver are right. If you did everything right, then one of your parts is defective and figuring out that part is another story which I might cover later in another video. But I hope that all your components are working out of the box, and with that hope, let's end the video. Like if you liked it, subscribe if you loved it, and don't forget to share this with someone you know who is building a PC. It might save a lot of their time. Alright, see you later.